ready now for another gold medal swim at Olympic Park Swimming Pool. Don Criqui with John Neighbor, and this is the men's 200-meter backstroke. It features American Dan Veach and also the world record holder and the favorite, Igor Polyansky of the Soviet Union. In fact, I think, John, two Soviet swimmers have to be considered the co-favorites, Sergei Zabolotnov. John Neighbor won four gold medals in Montreal in 76, a backstroker supreme. And John, tell us a little bit about the stroke.
Well, let's take a look at this swimmer swimming towards the camera. What I look for is a large shoulder rotation. Look at the angles in which the shoulders roll. In fact, almost close to vertical. As the swimmer moves, he's got to reach deep underwater on the pull, and he's got to recover way out of the water on the recovery. This will be the pull at motion itself. It's a sweeping motion with the arm. Once the arm gets to the shoulder, then it pulls up to the surface of the water and pushes down to the hips. Then the rotation brings the hand out of the water for the recovery again. We want to see a lot of shoulder rotation in this 200-meter event.
And now the gold medal field is out, and there is the world record holder, Igor Polyansky of the Soviet Union. He set the world record in East Germany in 1985. Rick Terry still has the Olympic record and the American record. Here's the other Russian. This is Sergei Zabolotnov, another Soviet swimmer who qualified first this morning, but Polyansky swam well within himself just to get in position for the finals. There is Dan Veach, an honors graduate of Princeton University, who swam well this morning, and he'll be in lane two. Gets a big ovation from the American contingent.
You know, that Princeton graduate's been shopping in Itaewon, buying himself a lifetime supply of pinstripe suits. He's already found himself a nice executive job after the Olympics.
Dan Veach, ready to go in lane two. There's strength up and down the eight lanes, though. Dirk Richter of East Germany in lane three is a formidable swimmer. That is the man to beat, Igor Polyansky, the world record holder from the Soviet Union. Rick Carey set that Olympic record in Los Angeles in 1984. And he also has the American record. He lowered that after the Olympics. Paul Kingsman swimming in lane one. Dan Veach in lane two. Dirk Richter from East Germany, lane three. Sergei Zabolotnov from the Soviet Union, lane four. Baltrush from East Germany, lane five. The world record holder, Polyansky from the Soviet Union, lane six. Peter Berndt, now swimming for West Germany, a defector from East Germany in 1985 in lane seven. And an 18-year-old Brazilian, Rogério Romero, swims in lane eight. This will be four lengths of the 50-meter pool.
They'll start in the water, Don, and you know how competitive the United States is at the national championships? Well, with the rewards that go to Soviet swimmers, a $19,000 cash prize for a gold medal, you can imagine the competitive juices flowing between Polyansky and Zabolotnov. They're both striving for national supremacy and all the benefits that go with it. Polyansky, the record holder, has got to be favored to a small degree, but frankly, he lacks discipline in the race. He loses to stupid finishes. So if everything goes well for him, he'll be in a nice position. But if it gets a little bit tough, Zabolotnov likes to run him down at the end and has done so in the last two meetings that I've seen.
They did it this morning in the qualifier.
Polyansky, when he gets lazy, starts looking around. Instead of keeping his head stationary and rolling the shoulders, he lets his head bobble around and he just stares at the ceiling and stares at the lanes and looks for the wall. And that's not a disciplined swim. Zabolotnov, on the other hand, is the contrary. He's a very, very intelligent swimmer. Smart, doesn't get thrown off by the fact that Polyansky will be a body length ahead three quarters of the way through the race. He just does his own thing. And generally, in a head-to-head matchup, Zabolotnov is the real threat.
So the swimmers go in the water. The one event, of course, the one style of swimming where you start in the water, the backstroke. Polyansky in lane six. Sergei Zabolotnov, his compatriot from the Soviet Union, in lane four. Polyansky comes from a place where there's not a lot of swimming pools. He's from Western Siberia.
See those flags over the water's edge? That tells the swimmers that the wall is coming, so there's no need to look around. The flags will tell you.
Finals of the men's 200-meter backstroke.
That was a jump by Polyansky. He was trying to take the advantage that he could by anticipating the start. Thing to look for here is There was no gun, and in fact, you don't lose your balance. Polyansky right here with the goggles. He's going to pull himself up to the starting block, and then he just goes for it. And he almost caught the official's gun. Had he been just a fraction later, the official would have had no reason to pull him back.
It is interesting also, John, this morning we saw two qualifiers disqualified because of false starts.
Yeah, they call it intentional false starting. Can't lose your balance. There was a little bit of hesitation on Polyansky. He almost went for it. Lane six, three from the bottom. He's doing that underwater backstroke kick. That Burkoff backstroke, and look at that.
Polyansky in lane six. He breaks the water and is in the lead. Six down from the top, three up from the bottom. Igor Polyansky, the world record holder in this four-length race, the 200-meter backstroke. Sergei Zavolatnov and Polyansky, the two Soviet swimmers, will go to the wall for the first turn. That is Polyansky who's in first. Did you see the underwater camera pick up the turn? Swimming between them very nicely from East Germany is Frank Baltrush in lane five.
Look at Polyansky's head, bobbing back, looking forward, bobbing back.
The American Dan Veach is two down from the top. He is well off the pace at this point as they come to the halfway point of the race. Zavolatnov now appears to have taken a slight lead over his countryman, Polyansky.
You know, I wish Zavolatnov luck before the competition began. And he smiled. He's in good spirits. And they're already ahead of world record pace.
They are indeed. They go out under world record pace through the first half of the race. Igor Polyansky off the turn now starts to extend his stroke and his power. And Igor Polyansky is the man swimming in the lead. Baltrush from East Germany next to him. And it is Zavolatnov swimming in lane four at the top of the screen, who is swimming third at the moment. As they now go to the final turn and 50 meters to swim for the gold medal.
Zavolatnov has a great 450. Don't count him out. But something happened on that turn. He looked like he faded. Polyansky's getting stronger.
That East German's not going away either, though, John. Baltrush is staying right in it.
And up there on the outside lane, Paul Kingsman from New Zealand. He's making a rush.
Yes, he is. In lane one of the top of the screen, that's Paul Kingsman from New Zealand. The slight leader now is Igor Polyansky in lane six. And he looks like he's going to have plenty to take into the wall over Baltrush of East Germany. And to the wall they go. The first place finisher for the gold is Igor Polyansky, the world record holder. He is over world record time. The second place finisher was Baltrush from East Germany. And Kingsman, who came on so strong in lane number one from New Zealand, Paul Kingsman, he gets the bronze, finishing third. The American entering the race, Dan Veach, finished seventh.
Polyansky led from the start. Let's watch that beginning again. Remember the goggles? He goes, and then as we look at him from above, he swims underwater with a long underwater dolphin kick. You see him there, still kicking underwater, and he explodes to the surface now with a huge pull and pop to the surface. Boom, and he's got a three-quarter body length lead. All the way to the finish, Polyansky still a little bit undisciplined. Look at his eyes, looking for the wall. Where on earth is the finish? Very sloppy, and that's one of the reasons he didn't break the world record. I hate to do this, Don, but immodestly, I have to say, my winning time from 12 years ago was faster than what he just did.
Well, we're saying, Polyansky has been criticized all along. He's a very poor turner. He's always looking at the flags, and still he holds the world record. Well, he swam well enough to win gold. And Polyansky gets the medal for the Soviet Union. Baltrush with silver for East Germany. Kingsman with bronze for New Zealand.